Greetings. This is a research and analysis video of the 188-day/377-day cycle, which has been attributed by some on the internet as causing powerful earthquakes over the last few years. This will be a video which will have a close-up look of the celestial bodies within this solar system and determining a possible cause for these very large earthquakes and their possible explanation. I'm now going to present my theory on how our solar system works and functions. All celestial bodies, asteroids, comets, everything contained within our solar system is moving harmoniously in resonant perfection around the Sun heliocentrically, singing their celestial symphony, which can be dubbed the music of the spheres. But from a specific planetary body, this perfect harmonic or celestial resonance is changing in its tone or tune as the orbital orientation changes from that perspective, and a very different tune or tone is then translated. So a planet which appears to be going stationary or backwards for a short time is actually an illusion, but from the planetary perspective, the sound and appearance of the celestial body is changing, and its very movement causes glitches in our 3D matrix, producing temporal distortions into our time continuum, as all planets in our solar system are singing a song that enables us to have our 3D reality. I have found that planetary alignments and retrograde cycles are causing temporal glitches in our 3D matrix. The movement of the planets with respect to the Earth creates a celestial resonance in our solar system or disturbance, which produces a matter exchange event or a standing wave shift. It's the movement of the planets and resonance attributed that affects the Earth and our reality, the same as a sun-diving comet moving through the Earth-Sun translation, affecting our Sun, but in a much larger celestial scale. It's a movement of the interplanetary magnetic fields that creates these temporal distortions. We're now looking at the planetary retrograde cycles a little bit more closely, where we see Mercury having three retrograde cycles a year, and each of them lasts for approximately 3 weeks. Venus, every 18 months, has a retrograde, and these last between 40 to 44 days. Mars, every 26 months, has a cycle, and these last approximately 60 to 80 days. We move to Jupiter, and it has a retrograde cycle every 13 months, and these last for 4 months, and this is very similar to Saturn's cycle, which is roughly every 12 and a half months, lasting approximately 4.5. And the other planets, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto, roughly have a cycle every 12 months, lasting approximately half the year. We're now going to look at this 188.5-day cycle a little bit more closely, as many online have used this date to sell fear and disinformation, and have used this date to say that they are causing significant earthquakes here on the Earth as far as tsunamis and also pole shift events. They have used a heavy mass object, a black star, and also Nibiru, and even Comet Elenin to associate themselves with this 188-day theoretical cycle. But if we multiply this by 2, we see it comes to 377 days, which is very close to a Saturn and Jupiter retrograde cycle. Now we can even take this one step further and say that the Moon is part of this 188.5-day cycle, as the frequency of penumbral eclipses is 1.12 years or 409 days. We also have between 12 to 13 full moons per year, and multiplying this by 29.5, we come up with 369, very close to the 377 days of this theoretical cycle. We're now looking at the last 16 years of Saturn retrogrades and cross-checking with significant earthquakes felt here on the Earth, and an interesting observation has been found. Shortly after a Saturn retrograde, a 7-magnitude earthquake has been found on each one of these years, and on 6 of these years, earthquakes were over 8-magnitude. Now, the last 3 earthquakes were very powerful. As we can see from this image, the last 3 years have produced very powerful earthquakes, and interestingly, they're all occurring virtually on the same point of the Saturn retrograde cycle, or from an Earth perspective, Saturn is turning backwards. We see that the magnitude 8.6 and 8.2 earthquakes on April 11, 2012 off the west coast of northern Sumatra, the magnitude 9.1 on March 11, 2011 off the east coast of Honshu, Japan, and also the magnitude 8.8 on February 27, 2010 in Biobío, Chile, all have strong similarities. Now I have listed on the right hand side of the screen the time gap between the Saturn retrograde and also this powerful earthquake that followed shortly after, and there is a spread from 5 to 50 days, but on average they occur every 29.18 days. Now from this analysis we can assume a very powerful earthquake would be possible during the month of March this year, 2013. Now with further analysis we get to see the time duration in between these very big earthquakes, and we do see that once they're averaged out over the last 16 years they are occurring every 382 days. So we should add 382 days to the date of April 11, 2012. We end up coming up with April 28, 2013, and this should be the date that may produce a very big event. And just so happen to have a planetary alignment and earthquake watch covering this date as well. And that'll be linked to the description box and also as a video response for anyone who's interested. Now, this date is also associated with two very strong planetary alignments, and I have assessed the earthquake potential to only a 7.8 magnitude. We're now looking at the last 18 years of Jupiter retrogrades, and there is a strong association with significant earthquakes with this cycle as well. And on three of the 18 years, powerful earthquakes were registered on the same day. A magnitude 6.5 earthquake in the southern East Pacific Rise on June 10, 1997. A magnitude 7.1 in the southeast of the Lofoten Islands region on January 3, 2004. And three significant earthquakes all registered on the same day in the Mora Gulf, Mindanao, Philippines region, magnitude 7.4, a 7.3 and another 7.4 magnitude, all on the same day of this Jupiter retrograde. Now, it is worth noting that the Jupiter retrograde cycle lasts for approximately 4 months. This is a regular cycle occurring every 13 months. Now, this is important and it does play a role in the 188-day cycle. I'll explain more on this shortly. Now, this image that we are looking at is showing the relationship at the very beginning of this Jupiter retrograde and the earthquakes associated slightly ahead and slightly after within a 9 or 10-day window. Now, I have added other planetary retrogrades in this image on the right-hand side to see if there's any coincidences or extra planetary influences that are producing stronger earthquakes felt here on the Earth. And we do see an interesting pattern when you merge Jupiter's retrograde cycle and Saturn's, and they do last for approximately 9 years. But the key factor is at the beginning and at the end of this cycle, significant earthquakes have been registered here on the Earth. A 7.7 magnitude earthquake struck Western Turkey, killing over 17,000 people at the beginning of this cycle in 1999. And we can see 9 years later, a very powerful 7.9 earthquake struck Eastern Sichuan, China, which killed over 68,000 at the very end of this very cycle. We currently have a very powerful earthquake swarm in progress in the Santa Cruz Islands region. All this activity began on the 1st of February with a cluster of 6 magnitude earthquakes. It just so happens that Jupiter was ending its retrograde cycle or going direct a day earlier. An escalation in earthquake activity in the region occurred on the 6th of February when an 8 magnitude earthquake struck the region. Now, what is interesting is that Saturn is due to move into its retrograde cycle on February 18th. So this very strong earthquake swarm is actually occurring in between both retrograde cycles of Jupiter and Saturn. So if we visualize our solar system, conceptually we can say that the movement in space and time of both Jupiter and Saturn has caused some sort of harmonic disturbance in the common carrier, which is the very fabric of our time continuum. We're now looking into 2014, and it does appear that it may be even stronger than 2013, as Jupiter and Saturn are much more strongly aspected, as we see that Saturn is moving into retrograde on March 2, 2014, while Jupiter is actually moving out of its retrograde 4 days later and going direct. And this does have some similarities back to 1999, with a significant earthquake that struck in Western Turkey that killed over 17,000 people. While researching retrograde motions of the planets and earthquakes felt here on the Earth, a very powerful earthquake was found in a Mars retrograde cycle in 2003, where an 8.3 magnitude earthquake struck Hokkaido, Japan region on September 25th. As mentioned, there have been three extremely large earthquakes over the last 3 years, all over 8.6 magnitude. Now, if we have a look at the position of Saturn, it was moving into Libra during its retrograde phase. And we'll have a look at this, as we do know that Saturn's cycle is 29.45 years on its orbit around the Sun. So that would mean if we go back in time, we can actually do some hindcasting to see if there were any significant earthquakes associated in the past. I've now plotted the last three Saturn retrograde cycles moving through Libra to find any symmetry and past earthquakes that matched the last 3 years, which were very devastating earthquakes felt here on the Earth. And there are some interesting observations. Although the last cycle was considerably weak, there were some significant earthquakes associated, the highest reaching 7.1 magnitude. But the two previous cycles produced very powerful earthquakes, an 8.6 in the Hokkaido, Japan region in 1952, and also in 1923, an 8.5 magnitude in the Kamchatka Peninsula region. Now, plotting these very large earthquakes on Google Earth, and there are some interesting symmetry that can be observed as Saturn was moving through Libra, and we actually see on this chart 20 degrees Libra back in 1923, 14 degrees Libra in 1952, and 17 degrees Libra in 2011, and we can see that the progression is moving south. Now, I find it very hard to believe that this can be considered as a coincidence. These are very powerful earthquakes affecting the same portion of the Pacific Plate. The Earth-centric model is our part in a much bigger mechanism expressed by our participation in this heliocentric field. In other words, we are harmonically tuned into this solar system with every planet and object contained within in absolute perfection, allowing us to have this 3D reality, because without one component, it simply just cannot work. Thus, the Earth-centric model shows how our 3D time-space can be affected. So from the model presented here, I feel it would be impossible for any extraplanetary body to be entering our solar system, and I feel it would immediately disturb the natural harmonic foundation of the solar system itself by perturbing planetary bodies out of their existing orbits and into new orbits, or completely out of the solar system, meaning that our solar system will then lose its true harmonic aspects, and at that point we will lose our 3D reality, as the celestial symphony that created our solar system will then become out of phase. Therefore, we can categorically say that there is no such thing as a 188-day earthquake cycle, and those selling this have a very limited view and awareness and understanding of astronomy and how the solar system functions. These types are always looking for phantoms and boogeymen to sell their fears and books, seeking attention. They're ultimately just selling a lie. It is obvious that there is a much bigger cycle within cycles that is at play, which is a natural part of this solar system. And that's my research and analysis of the 377-day earthquake cycle that I've attributed to the harmonic retrograde movements of Jupiter and Saturn. For more information, please visit my website at solarwatcher.net. I'll now add a small clip at the end of this video regarding the polytomic model of the universe, which is the Earth at the center of the solar system with the Sun and planets revolving around, and their harmonic retrograde movements. Thanks for watching.